You can see the rain pattering down onto the lake here at Eton. Never a nice sight, but that is a nicer sight, the crews in line and all ready to perform. A reminder that Poland are in one, Great Britain in two, Australia, the world champions, in three, Estonia in four, Croatia in five, and Germany in six. Croatia with three World Cup wins this year. Can they add an Olympic gold?
3 minutes.
Still 3 minutes to the start of this highly anticipated men's quadruple sculls. The Croatian four, led by David Sain at bow, 6 feet one. He's had 11 World Cup wins in all throughout his career and one World Championship. Number two is Martin Sinkovic, who says he wants to be a chef when he's finished with his rowing career. In three, Damian Martin, whose mother and grandfather were both rowing champions. He was a refugee in 1991, fleeing to Croatia. And the boat completed by Valent Sinkovic, elder brother of Martin, who serves in the armed forces. That's the Croatian boat.
2 minutes.
Russia hold the racing world best time this year. System. Australia the Olympic best 4 years ago. Here is that start list for you. Poland, Great Britain, Australia, Estonia, Croatia, and Germany. Only Australia coming from outside of Europe. Wasilewski, Kolbowicz, Jelinski, and Korol, the Polish four. Kolbowicz, by the way, at the age of 41, easily the oldest man in the contest. Stephen Rowbotham, Charles Cousins, Tom Salisbury, and Matthew Wells at stroke, representing Great Britain. Wells from Bradford, known as the Red Express. From Australia, Chris Morgan, Carsten Forsterling, James McRae, and Daniel Noonan. A plumber by trade. In lane four, the Estonians are in the hands of Andrei Jamsa, Ala Raja, Tonu Hendrickson, and Kasper Taimsu. All well over 6 feet tall. And for Croatia, the favourites, David Sain, Martin Sinkovic, Damian Martin, and Valent Sinkovic. And the Germans are in lane six today. The World Cup runners-up earlier this year, Karl Schulze, Philipp Wender, Laurit Schuf, and Tim Grohmann.
Poland, Great Britain, Australia, Estonia.
The announcer informs the Croatia crowd of the identities of the competing
Germany
nations.
Attention.
Before we await for that green light and the bell. The first medal of the day will be decided in the next few minutes. This the final of the men's quadruple sculls. So there's gold to be won out there. And if the green and golds can take it of Australia. In the hands of the engineer from Adelaide, Chris Morgan. The man who loves restoring cars from Melbourne, Forsterling. Or the 6'4" McRae from Adelaide, whose two sisters both row. And Daniel Noonan from Sydney. It's a lead in the early stages for Germany. Schultz was in the army in Dresden. Wender also in the army, and Schuf, who's a student in Rendsburg, Roman, a third member of this team who's in the serving forces. And Germany does lead towards the 500 metre point of the race. But in last spot at the moment are Estonia in lane four. Poland in one have a bit of room, bit of ground to make up as well. The Olympic champions, the reigning champions, Poland. Wasilewski, one of those who took gold in Beijing, along with Kolbowicz. He was inspired, he said, by Stephen Redgrave. Jelinski also was in Beijing, the only newcomer to the Polish belt is Adam Korol. But they're down in sixth place at the moment. Germany went through in 124.1 in the lead. Not by a great deal, as you would expect at 500 metres. By the time we get to 1,000 metres, such a lead would be more meaningful. As a unit, they impress. And put in hours of training. Sometimes as much as 6 hours a day on the lakes and the rivers in their own country, back in Germany. But it's a good lead that the Germans have established, and we are moving towards the halfway mark in the race. First, coming down the lake at Eton Dorney towards the line that shows halfway. There it is, there's the white line. 1,000 metres, Germany have negotiated in 2:51.6, almost a second up on Croatia. Great Britain are third and in a hunt for a bronze medal at the moment, which would go down very well here. Great Britain in the lead in the medals table with one gold, one silver and one bronze so far. They are in the chasing pack as Germany strike out over the closing 1,000 metres of the lake. Karl Schulzer at bow, Tim Grohmann at stroke. Going very well at the moment, going very easily. Pushing up now are Croatia in lane 5. The ones we expect to push up. And this is where they've decided to make their move. The three-time World Cup winners this year. Croatia trying to close the gap on Germany, but they've been unsuccessful in that quest so far. Australia also having a good little session on the water now. They appear to be moving into a clear third position ahead of the British and ahead of the Estonian and Polish crews. Coming to 1,500 metres, Germany still has that lead. Going through in second now, Croatia with Australia 3, Estonia 4, Great Britain dropping back into fifth place. Now the crowd start to cheer, they're hoping for a British push. A late charge from the British, but it may be beyond them in this race. I think it is. Germany look good. Germany look good for gold. It would be their second gold to go with one silver already. The German 4. Schulzer, Wender, Schulz and Grohmann appear to be headed for gold here at Eton. And there will be delight in the German camp about this race. Croatia are pushing hard now to try and get up alongside them, trying to get into gold rather than silver position. But it's Germany who leads, and still by at least the length of a boat. A very healthy advantage enjoyed by Germany. Australia appear to be pushing close now on Croatia in the bid for silver. The Australian boat in the hands of Chris Morgan, Carsten Forsterling, James McRae and Daniel Noonan are trying to edge into second, but it's gold for Germany, it is silver just for Croatia and bronze for Australia. Estonia came in fourth and Great Britain were in fifth. The kissing and the cuddling can start for the Germans. Carl Schulzer stands up first. He's now joined by Loritz Schufin celebrating. These big men, 6'3", 6'4", 6'5", and 6'6", the four Germans. The Croatians may have won three times in the World Cup in 2012, but when it came to the Olympics, they were bettered by the Germans, the formidable Germans, and the Australians settled for a bronze. And look at the effort that they've put in. It's testament to, whoops, they're going to go over if they're not careful. They wouldn't care. And so they deserve their moment in the spotlight. The German Gold Cup winners of 2012 in the men's quadruple sculls. The second German gold in the rowing. 5:42.48 was the winning time. Almost 2 seconds up on Croatia, and Australia did really well to get that third spot and bronze medals ahead of Estonia, with Great Britain in fifth, and the Olympic champions of 4 years ago, Poland, right out of it in sixth.